What I mean, you've followed this case from the beginning. So, what are the hopes of the investors getting their money back from the IMA?
See, first of all, SIT has done a wonderful job in recovering most of the properties which he has left back. And it's up to the courts now. SIT can't do anything. All those people have lodged in their FIRs. They have to approach the honorable courts in the jurisdiction and submit their relevant documents. And then it up to the court to decide, you know, how do they go about it. And they may come to a conclusion that saying that you have taken already so much back, only this is left you can take. And some who have not, just invested recently, I think they'll also have to produce the documents and show where did they get the money from. And so it's up to the courts to decide. And how long the court's going to take, it's up to the courts to decide.
What are the problems, likely problems that could arise as a result of, you know, all the confusion in the case itself?
See, actually the confusion is that amount is very less. I think 1040 crores or 1000 crores which he has to give back. There are more than 1 lakh complainants are there and many have still not complained. So it remains to be seen how the money is divided. Like supposing a person who has invested 5 lakhs, how much will he get back? And the poor people who have invested 1 lakh or 50,000, which is the minimum 50,000, they won't be having a problem. But if they have invested in a period of 8 to 10 years before, it's up to the court, because you know, we can't say anything, and the authorities, income tax will be involved in this, and enforcement director, and whether income tax has been paid or not, and all his properties have been come under KPID Act, and then enforcement director act will be there, money laundering act will be there. They'll see whether income tax has been paid, what returns investor is getting if he has not paid his income tax. So he has to pay that income tax in that annually. Like supposing he has got more than 5 lakh rupees per annum return, so he has to pay his thing.
Now, if you do you see a large amount of corruption across the board, politicians, police?
Yeah, unless there is no support from the government officials or from the politicians, nobody can run such a scam. It's a very sad.
Just one second, sir. Can you say that again, sir?
It's very sad that, you know, nobody can run a scam or nobody can think without the convenience of the officials or thing. Because see, when the RBI came to know and they set up an inquiry, the district magistrate, DC North and assistant commissioner, they issued notices and then they gave a clean sheet. Why they gave a clean sheet? It has come out that they were bribed. So the system itself was, you know, he saw that system is corrupt and he tried to play on with it. Ultimately, it was one IAS officer who would not sign on the NOC that nailed the story, his scam.